We're here with Senate Minority Leader, Senator from Dubuque, Pam Jochum. We're just getting out of the condition of the state speech. We'll get into more of the details here, too. I just want to know, what were some of your big takeaways, and what are some things are you taking away from the governor said that?
Sure. Well, you know, the Senate Democrats really want to work with the governor and the Republicans on creating more freedom, opportunity, and of course more accountability for our government. So we're more than willing to work with the governor and the Republican majority on those things we can't agree with. One thing that came up was, of course, the 12-month postpartum for moms on Medicaid. That is truly a piece of legislation that Democrats have fought to get passed for the last several years, including last year on the Health and Human Service budget. So I was glad to hear that she's now advocating for that. But I will tell you that there were some qualifiers in her speech that truly raised some red flags for me. So we truly want to work on these issues, but we need to see the bills. We really need to see the details of what it is she's trying to accomplish.
And what Republicans were letting me know, too, is education will once again be a top priority. Coming off of the tragedy at the Parity community last Thursday, the governor starting with that, having a state trooper that was here and helping provide support, saving the life of an individual as well. She started off talking about changes to AEAs that started last year, concerns for it, Iowans and Democrats specifically, too. Her plan right now, where it's allowing schools to float in between the bill proposal, I guess, what are your just initial reactions?
The area education agencies truly are near and dear to my heart. I had a daughter with severe intellectual disabilities, and I know how important the AEAs were to my family and to every other family that has a child with special needs. My concern is the way, again, I want to see what the details are in her proposal. Right now, it sounds like we are moving more and more toward even privatization of the AEAs as well. So I really want to see, we all do, we want to see the details.
So let's start right here. You're talking about some bipartisan things that you think that Democrats will be able to go along with. Teacher pay, bumping that up to $50,000 here in the state, $62,000 minimum for teachers of experience of 12 years. That's $96 billion. What are your thoughts about that? Do you think that's going to be able to happen?
You know, we love our teachers. And I know over the last couple of years, some of the things that the Republican majority has done, they have really beaten out and beaten down on our teachers. So I'm glad to hear this because I love our teachers. They are the ones that are preparing the future of our country and our state. So let me just say this, that right now the average starting income for teachers is around $39,000. So this is certainly an improvement. The average salary for teachers in our state right now, for everyone, regardless of how long they've been teaching, is around $59,000. So to push it up to $62,000 for someone who's got 12 years experience, good stuff. Love it. What happens to someone who has spent their entire career and has been in teaching for 25 years? Will they also see an increase? Will all ships rise with this, or is it going to be very isolated? So again, we want to see the details.
Yeah, we'll be talking about the details here, too. We got to get to a couple more topics here, last couple questions for you, too. They're going to speed up the income tax rate changes that were just passed 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. They're seeing the 1% decline every single year for the state budget, the state tax revenue. What are your concerns about speeding it up? The current rate right now is 5.7%. If a bill passes, it'd be 3.65% now in this state. Any concerns?
Sure, absolutely I have concerns about it. So let me tell you that we've been watching these tax cuts being phased in over the last couple years. I can tell you that the top 1%, and I'm not exaggerating, the top 1% of this state has gotten the benefit of that tax cut. Those are 3,400 Iowans who make more than $1 million a year. They have benefited from this tax cut. So what I want to see again is the details. What I know is that the projections on the current phase out of the taxes is about $1.8 billion in another year. How do we make up that difference? At what point do we end up in some really difficult budget times? So again, details are what is most important to us right now.
The governor, once again, too, ending with foreign ownership of land, it's going to be enhancing reporting. Not a whole lot of details on that, too, but just, I guess, hearing the enhancing reporting, enforcement, potentially increasing fines, is there any concerns for that?
You know, of course, we are all very supportive of making sure that Iowa farmland is protected from foreign ownership, and we will try and do our best to work with on that issue. Mm-hmm. But again, we need to see the bill.
That's all the questions I have. Is there any other final takeaways, I guess, that you want to share with our
The final takeaway would be we really do want to make sure that we are making sure that there is more freedom, opportunity, and accountability of government. And we'll be looking very closely at the bill that will be coming out on how we're consolidating state government and boards and commissions, because that, again, is critically important to the health and safety of Iowans.
Actually, I wanted to ask one question on that. You brought it up. Did you think there was enough public input, and were lawmakers involved in that?
Absolutely not enough input. In my humble opinion, it was a sham operation.
All right. Well, thank you for bringing that
You're
up, too. I
forgot
to ask that. Senator Jochum, the Senate Minority Leader, thanks for joining us.
You're
the condition of the state.
Thank you.